Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host Meenu, and these are the major news stories of Thursday, February 15th, 2024. The Supreme Court on Thursday struck down the electoral bond scheme for political funding, calling it unconstitutional, arbitrary, and violative of Article 14. As the farmers' Delhi Chalo protest has entered its third day on Thursday, the leaders have declared a rail blockade in Punjab. The Samyukt Kisan Morcha has also supported the ongoing protest, which demand the minimum support price or MSP for their crops. Further depleting the strength of the India bloc, the National Conference has decided to go at it alone in the upcoming Lok Sabha elections in Jammu and Kashmir. At least one person was killed and 21 others, including several children, wounded after a mass shooting at the Kansas City Chiefs Super Bowl victory rally on Wednesday triggered panic among huge crowds of fans. The Kerala government has decided to increase the prices of 13 essential food items distributed through supply co outlets. The prices of these items were kept low due to the subsidies of up to 70%. In a landmark judgment that delivered a big blow to the government, the Supreme Court on Thursday annulled the electoral bond scheme for political funding, saying it violates the constitutional right to freedom of speech and expression as well as the right to information. In its verdict months ahead of the Lok Sabha polls, the apex court ordered the State Bank of India to disclose to the Election Commission the names of the contributors to the six-year-old scheme. According to the electoral bond scheme, notified by the central government in 2018, the bonds may be purchased by any citizen of India or entity incorporated or established in the country. An individual can buy electoral bonds either as a single or jointly with other individuals without disclosing their identity. As the farmers' Delhi Chalo protest has ended its third day, the Bharatiya Kisan Union and BKE As the farmers' Delhi Chalo protest has ended its third day, the Bharatiya Kisan Union and BKU Dakaunda have declared a rail blockade in Punjab on Thursday. The Samyukt Kisan Morcha, an umbrella body of 37 farm unions, have also supported the ongoing protest. The protesters are demanding a minimum support price or MSP for their crops. The police have deployed tear gas shells to disperse the protesters in the past 2 days, prompting the farmers to take precautions. The farmers equipped themselves with water bottles, wet clothes, and even protective gear to minimize the impact of tear gas. The police have sealed the border with barricades, preventing farmers from traveling to Delhi on their tractor trolleys. Further depleting the strength of the India bloc, the National Conference has decided to go at it alone in the Lok Sabha elections in Jammu and Kashmir. Former Chief Minister Farooq Abdullah announced the decision at a press conference on Thursday. Coming on the heels of announcements by Bengal Chief Minister and TMC leader Mamata Banerjee and Punjab Chief Minister and Aam Aadmi Party leader Bhagwant Mann, who said that they would have no truck with the Congress in the general election, the latest move by National Conference would be a major setback for the opposition alliance. At least one person was killed and 21 others, including several children, wounded after a mass shooting at the Kansas City Chiefs Super Bowl victory rally on Wednesday triggered panic among huge crowds of fans. 3 people were taken into custody following the incidents. The bloodshed, which came at the end of the rally following a parade, turned the festive occasion into a scene of panic as throngs of attendees scrambled for cover at the sound of rapid-fire gunshots. 11 of those hurt by gunfire or the ensuing pandemonium were children as young as 6, said officials. None of the football team, the coaches, or other staff attending the rally was injured. The Kerala government has decided to increase the prices of 13 essential food items distributed through supply co outlets. The prices of these items were kept low due to the subsidies of up to 70%. However, following the latest decision of the state cabinet, the maximum subsidy will be 35% on market rates. This decision is observed as a departure from the policy of the first Pinarayi Vijayan ministry, which had refused to increase the prices of subsidized items. Meanwhile, the Minister for Food and Civil Supplies, G.R. Anil, argued that the Civil Supplies Department was forced to take such a stand for the survival of the Supplyco outlets, which are on the verge of collapse. In protest to the decision, the opposition UDF disrupted the last session of the 15th Kerala Legislative Assembly, keeping the house in the dark. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Talks, hosted by me, Meenu, and produced by Vishnu Muralitharan with technical support from IDBRU Studios. Follow www.onmanorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.